What's up guys and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we're going to be discussing the career mode for F1 2016, the starting team that I'm going to be debuting when the game comes out on the 19th of August. So I always do this year on year, I always ask for your guys' feedback, your input as to what team I should drive for the start of a brand new career mode series. I'm going to leave a vote in the comments, but more importantly I'm going to leave a straw poll which should leave more of an easier way for me and all of you guys to see which is the most popular vote, to see which team I'll drive for Season 1 of Career Mode on F1 2016. So I'm going to go through the list of teams and just talk about, you know, what kind of career mode you might get by choosing a particular team. And it's going to be broken down by this tweet that I saw on Twitter last night. And it basically shows all the vehicle performances. It's a vehicle comparison, and it's also used very handily for your R&D upgrades and all that kind of thing, like a ladder, like I've talked about in previous videos. So I'll put the tweet on screen now, and as you can see, we've got Mercedes, Ferrari, Red Bull, Williams, all the teams there in a little index, and it goes from fastest to slowest. So I'm kind of going to group these guys together and just talk about if we go with a particular team, what kind of career mode we're going to get. So starting off with the likes of Manor, Sauber, and Renault, if you go with those three teams, we're ultimately going to be doing like a Road to Glory career mode series. So we're going to be starting off in a very slow team. It's going to be very, very hard to score points. It might only happen at Monaco or something like that. Season 1 will be a grind. And if I go with a team like this, it's ultimately going to be a long-term career mode where I build up the team and try and get them to in the midfield, more towards the front of the grid. So that's what I'm aiming at if I was to do a career mode with one of those three teams. Now you come into the next group, and I'd say that's Haas, McLaren, Force India, and Toro Rosso. That's kind of like the midfield guys. And I suppose from there, you're always within a striking distance of scoring points every single race. And at the occasional race, for example, Monaco, you may score a podium every so often. So if you want that kind of career mode, then vote for one of those few teams, in the straw poll, or also leave your reasoning in the comments if you want to really, I guess, put your opinion forward. And then finally, moving on to the top four teams, we've got Williams, Red Bull, Ferrari, and Mercedes. I am almost certain I'm not going to go with Mercedes. I never do, because we've always seen that the AI, if you go with the best team, it's not really the kind of career mode you want to watch, if that makes sense, because you're going to be at the front, you're only going to be battling your teammate, and almost always, you're always, well, me personally, and other people who do career modes, you're normally always faster than your teammate, so you're going to be racing by yourself, and who wants to see that? So, if you want to go with Williams, Red Bull, or Ferrari, we're going to be regularly scoring, you know, top five finishes every single race. The podiums are going to be pretty gettable as well. And you're going to see multiple race wins in the first season of career mode. So that's the kind of career mode where we'll be battling for the championship, battling with the top teams in Formula One, and also trying to edge out Mercedes Formula One team as the best car. Because when you're that close to Mercedes, with a season's worth of development, maybe a season and a half, you might be very, very close to Mercedes in terms of performance. Just bear in mind that F1 2016 is going to be very different to all the previous iterations of career mode, because your car is always going to get faster as you develop it and develop it. So, if anything, you want to go with a slower team just to make that progression, I don't know, a little bit nicer. Like, the point of a career mode is to start off low and then build your way up and then get glory near the end. So, ultimately, if it was down to me, I would probably choose one of the backmarkers or somewhere in the midfield range. So, that's the kind of career mode that I want to do. That's the kind of career mode that I think might be the most exciting. And I'm just interested to see what you guys make of this and which team is going to be the most popular. I'm very, very keen to see how this one goes. Ultimately, the vote is not going to decide which team I'm going to drive for. Of course, I'm going to take it into consideration. That's why I'm holding a vote and seeing what you guys make of it. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. Leave your vote in the comments. But more importantly, make sure you vote in the straw poll in the link down in the description. If you miss it there, it's going to be on my Twitter. And I'll probably talk about the career mode a little bit more on my Twitter. So follow me over on there. And one last thing, I set up a PO box fairly recently. So if you want to send me like mail or art or anything like that, then I'll leave the details for that on the screen, or I'll leave them in the description down below. So once again, guys, thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. F1 2016, it's coming out in less than a month's time, and I can't wait. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.